So in this video, which is a bonus video for the second session, I will give a sneak preview of the Zertifizierungsportal of the KBW. So what the KBW has is they have a portal where you can click on Testdaten validieren, so validate test data. And basically this will give you the possibility to validate the bundles that you're generating. So there's a new version of the eRecept validator. It's now version 1.0.1. And what you have to do is you have to zip your file. So, and now let's just write our current file to the file here, pbn0.xml. So this is the name what the file has to have. And then we just need some bytes. So let's do byte, or let's just put this here. So let's add throws declaration. Here we go. So then save, run this example here. And this now created this pv1.xml file. Let's go to this folder and then let's zip this. And you have to use a special name. So the test file, it has to start with test underscore 410. This is important. And then three arbitrary numbers. And then you just do a zip. And now what you can do is you go to the Prüfportal. Let's make this a little bigger. Then you upload this file. You don't have to input an email address, so this is optional. Just put in the capture. And then you just click on validate test data. And this will validate the test data. And if there's only one file in there, it should also be quite fast. So if you have a full package, which really has all the 10 PPF files in there, it will take a lot longer. But now if you go onto the protocol of the HTML, you will see that only the first file is there, and you can also see that there's lots of stuff wrong. So it complains that I'm using a 1.0.2 profile, but it has to be a 1.0.1 profile. It complains that all the data is wrong, so it expects Karl Friedrich Schaumberg, but it was Manuel Blechschmidt. And there are also lots of other stuff which is wrong. But it should just give you a sneak preview what you have to do to make these test cases working. Thanks a lot and see you in the next video.